for him. Now, a guy who's really helped the offense from a defensive standpoint, Dave Elliott. You heard Brian Murray mention him coming in as that man on rushes. He's a real key on their power play. They kind of use kind of a diamond set of setup using Randy Carlisle as the lone point man back up in the middle. Elliott sneaking down on one of the wings, and keep an eye for that. And Dave Elliott trailing the play. So the Cats forwards are going to have to be very, very responsible tonight to stop Dave Elliott in his offensive foray. Now, the guy who may be having the best overall season for the Winnipeg Jets is Thomas Steen, an 8-year veteran. Here's a guy who has always done his job very, very quietly. He's got nice offensive skills. He's an outstanding skater, very smart defensively, one of the only guys really with a positive plus-minus for the Winnipeg Jets. So you've got a team that's having some very disappointing seasons, but in Thomas Steen, he's given the Jets some real solid second-line play.
We talked recently about the big game that was had in Montreal and then in Boston, psychologically and on the ice, for Jeff Courtnall of the Washington Capitals. You follow that with another fine performance against a Patrick Division win on a team like the New York Rangers, and you've really got him rolling.
And he's rewarded for that effort by being named the National Hockey League Player of the Week. 5 goals, picking up their assists to go along with that in the 3 games. And Jeff Courtnall, people were worried about him repeating his output from last year when he scored 36 goals. We've got 35 now, and he's got 10 games to still go to see if he can better that. Courtnall has given the Capitals a consistent effort most of the year, and again becomes the key to that power play. When he's shooting the puck, when he's getting that shot away quickly, when the Capitals point men in particular are setting him with those nice passes for those diagonal passes for the one-timer, Capitals special teams and the power play unit is very, very strong. That's going to be a key to the playoffs, and Courtnell's got to keep producing with the extra man.
We talked about the fact that the Capitals would like to get the crowd into this game. They're not in here in the same frame of mind or mood, let's say, as for the Rangers or for the Philadelphia Flyers or somebody, but you can understand that. They sure seem to appreciate Dino Cicerelli, though, the other night. I think you get him going early in the game, and they'd be right in.
Oh, he's the type of guy who could bring this crowd right back, and he was so happy with the reception. Worried before the game, how would they respond to him? People holding up signs, Dino, the chance of Dino, and he really gave him something to cheer about with that goal that tied the game 2-2. So he's a much more relaxed hockey player, but still very enthusiastic. Still wants to make sure he finishes up the regular season with a bang and gets everybody on his side.
Got a big round of applause tonight when he was introduced, in fact, as a member of the starting lineup. Well, the Capitals and the Winnipeg Jets all set to go, lined up with their respective blue lines for the playing and singing of the national anthem. Right now, let's turn things over downstairs to our public address announcer here at the Capitol Center, Marv Brooks.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, would you all please rise and join Glenn Cunningham in singing the Canadian and American national anthem.
Love and all my sons come and
Terry Fraser, the linesmen Gord Brassiker, and rookie Brian Murphy. Now a look at the starting goaltenders for tonight's contest. For the Winnipeg Jets, it'll be Elton Pokey Reddick. 10 wins, 15 losses, and 7 ties on the season in 38 games. 135 goals against, a 4.21 average. No shutouts. And young Bob Asenza will back him up. For the Washington Capitals, it once again is Pete Peters. 15 wins and 6 losses with 3 ties on the year. In 27 games, 70 goals against, a 2.81 average. And 4 shutouts. Don Beaupre is the backup goaltender for Washington. Ben Gustafson at center ice, set to work against Howard Chuck. Howard Chuck wins the draw, and we're underway. Now cleared across the blue line by Cicerelli, but poked back to center ice by the Jets. And into the Winnipeg zone. Pete Taglianetti throws it back into the Washington end, and here's Rod Langway back to get it. The Washington captain leads it out to Cicerelli at center ice. He tries to poke it past Carlisle. Now Taglianetti takes over for Winnipeg. Thrown back into the Washington zone. Peters forced to play it. Gives a little fake in the corner, keeping Paul Fenton away, and then tosses it behind the net. Back to the point. Here's a shot. Blocked, and Sheehy goes to the backboard chasing Fenton. Rod Langway recovers. Langway picks an opening and clears it down. The Capitals want a line change. And it's picked up in behind the Winnipeg goal. Fenton dumps it in from center ice. Now Winnipeg gets a change in, and here's Peters clearing it up the boards on the left wing side for Michael Pavaka. Pavaka works to center, gets across the blue line, and at the Winnipeg line, Kelly Miller came in first. Offside is called. Well, missing tonight from the lineup, the Jets with several injuries. Here are the Washington scratches. Peter Sundstrom also injured. He's out with a knee problem. Kevin Hatcher's broken foot just about healed. Lou Franceschetti being bothered by an ankle problem. And Scott Kleinendorst is scratched from the Washington lineup. Smale has a broken cheekbone. Numanen with a shoulder injury. And it's the same story for Ellenuk. Dave Ellen back to his own line. Turns it over to Fred Olesen, and now extends all the way down the ice back into the Washington zone. It's icing if Stevens gets there first. He does. And the whistle blows to stop play. Rick Bonus, the new coach of the Jets, and a lot of people felt that the old regime should have still stayed on in Winnipeg. I don't know that a lot of people in Winnipeg necessarily agreed with that, but a lot of hockey people respected Maloney. They respected Ferguson. They thought those people should continue.
Well, Dan Maloney figured as soon as John Ferguson was fired, he was going to be next. So he was not surprised by it. People have been talking about Rick Bonus and the organization anyway. 4-11-2 under Rick Bonus.
Played a lot of hockey during his professional career. He's a member of the St. Louis Blues organization. Spent a number of seasons in Salt Lake City in the Central Hockey League. And really worked his way up. Spent some time as an assistant. Coached in the minors. Put in some years in Moncton. Paid his dues.
I'd say he's a little more upbeat, a little more positive with the players. There are a couple people, Steen and Ashton, playing a little better under him than they were under Maloney.
At the point, here's Felix with the puck over to Scott Stephens. Now back to Kelly Miller. Cuts in, takes it behind the net. Now he's checked in the corner by Howard Chuck, the Winnipeg captain. Miller's still moving it and works it away from Ellis. Ridley tries to get in front. Here's the shot. It's deflected just wide by Reddick with his arm. Now Stevens backs it up. Ridley goes to the corner. He gets to Kelly Miller. Jammed on the play. Ellis takes it free. Now it's loose to the corner and grabbed there by Michael Pavanka. He throws it behind the net. Mike Ridley back to get it. Held up by Olesen. Pavanka tries to keep it in, but can't. The puck comes out to center ice, and Felix tosses it right back in to the Winnipeg zone. Both the Capitals and the Jets are beginning line changes once more, and here's Ridley across the blue line. Right to backhand, it goes into the corner for Bob Gould. Gould hit, now it's thrown right in front.
Defense. Winnipeg couldn't get the puck
Nick Bane, who's got a terrible plus minus, a minus 34. You can add one more to that as he lets Michael Pavanka get by him. Great work, though, done by the Capitals. And Mike Gridley, Kelly Miller, Pavanka had keyed most of that. The Capitals got one-third of their line change in. Bobby Gould was that man in. He gets things going. Michael Pavanka puts the Caps on top. Let's see how hungry the Capitals are now and see if they can add to this lead and get that crowd really roaring.
Ridley and Gould assisting at 2:35 of the first period on the Washington scoring play. Here's Jim Kite back on the Winnipeg defense. Has his pocket picked by Korsdahl. His shot deflected wide into the corner. Now it's thrown off the sideboard. And Brent Hughes tries to make the play. Gives it to Jim Kite. Kite steers it out to center and it rolls back inside Washington territory. And here's Calle Johansson back to play it. Johansson over to Rouse. Ahead to Johansson on the right wing to Stephen Lee. He gets across the blue line inside the Winnipeg zone. Lee back to Korsdahl. Deeks his way in front. A shot and a goal! Pokey Redick thought he had that one, but it just walked across the goal line, and Washington takes the lead of 2-0.
Big goal for Korsdahl at 36, matching last year's total. Look how much room he's got. Two guys converge in front of Wickenheiser. Nobody bothers to come out to Korsdahl. Redick gets a piece of it, but lets it go by him. This is just unbelievable. You see how nobody's out there. You get two guys tied up in front of Wickenheiser. Time is still over on the board. And Jeff Korsdahl has got a ton of room and plenty of time to operate. And the Caps showing some of that hunger we talked about.
Johansson and Leaf assisting on Korsdahl's 36th of the season at 3:44 of the first period. Capitals up 2-0. Here comes Leaf across the line. His shot blocked and cleared back to the point. Now a break for Winnipeg down the left wing side. Here comes Randy Gillen. His blast is blocked by Pete Peters. The puck cleared out to Steve Leaf. And Washington again on the comeback. A 4-on-2 rush. Here's John Bruce into the corner. Jammed up with the play. Leaf tries to work it free. Takes it behind the net. Now it's chased into the corner by Carlisle. Randy Carlisle flips it end over end out to center, and Gilhan gets a stick on it. It's taken over now by the Jets' Brad Berry. Berry dumps it back into the Washington zone, and Scott Stevens is back to play. Capitals lead 2-0, 15 minutes and 13 seconds to go here in the first period. Dave Christian across the line, gives to Gustafson. At the side of the Winnipeg net, it's grabbed now by Brent Ashton. Here comes Ashton starting out. Leaves it ahead to Paul Fenton, across the blue line to Ellis. And offside is called as Ashton came in early. There's a break in the action with the Capitals leading the Jets 2-0.
This year, if you really want to get money back, listen to Henry Block.
Go to Subaru.
Up to $1,500 cash back or 4.9 APR financing.
Of all the Subarus registered since 1978, 92% are still on the road, which could mean this four-wheel drive Subaru will still be good on a hill when other cars are over it.
14:59 left to play in this first period. The Caps roaring to a 2-0 lead over Winnipeg. I'm Al Kolkin along with Mike Borns and Jeff Rimmer, bringing you the action from a sold-out Capitol Center, live and exclusively on Home Team Sports.
Here's Chris Felix down the right wing now for the Capitals. He fires a shot wide. Gustafson goes to the corner, sends it up the boards, and Felix tries to keep it in. He does. Taken behind the net now by Olofsson. Off the boards to Ashton. Works to center ice. Dino Ciccarelli held up there, and the puck drawn back again to Dave Ellett. Ellett, left side pass to Fenton across the blue line, drops it off. It's taken by Ashton. Puts it behind the net. Fenton can't center, and it's grabbed by Washington's Ben Gustafson. Scott Stevens, dangerous pass right in front of his own net, but it's out of the zone safely, and now here's Ellett back to the Washington line. Gustafson holds him up there, and play is called. A lot of traffic in front of that goal when that pass was made.
see if we can maybe gamble a little bit with.
From the draw, the Capitals again in control, and here is Bob Rouse on defense wearing number 8. Get back inside the Winnipeg zone, and Reddick makes the save, and up the boards all the way back to the blue line of Washington. Johansson back after it. Right side for Rouse. Up to Ridley, gets across the blue line. Height goes to the corner. He's checked by Kelly Miller. Back to the point. Kelly Johansson looks to the side of the net. Ridley tries to dig it free. He centers. Bounces back to the goal again. Ridley out front. Here's Pavelka. Shot.
Defense point just dribbles the shot in. 3-0 Capitals. Pavanka with 2 now in this hockey game.
Here's Langway to start back. Dumps it inside the Jet zone. Hunter digs it out and throws it in front for Cortnall, but it bounces away from his stick. Back come the Jets on the attack. At the blue line. Langway right there to hold up Yarvinpah. Now Hunter starts back. They're going to give Johansson the goal. It looked like it was deflected twice on the way home. Ridley and Pavanka. So it hit Ridley as well. And then finally, Johansson right in front of the net. And he'll take credit for the goal. It's his first goal as a Washington Capital. And on the season, that gives him 3 for the year from Ridley and Pavanka at 6:28 of period number 1. Jets come out again. Boschman to center ice. Taken away by Leach, and Ellett throws it on the right wing. Dumped back inside the Washington zone by Gord Donnelly. On the right wing side, here's Stephen Leach out to center. Knocked free at the red line, and Brent Hughes again back to chase it. Puck cleared off the side glass, and Leach gets it to the point. Ellett fires a shot. And that one snuck right in on goal, but Peter's got his stick on it. Now a hard hit in the corner. Hughes and Leach collide. Peter's back of the net, leaves it there for Chris Felix. Felix starts out on the attack. Headmans the puck to Doug Wickenheim. He's across the blue line. Inside the Winnipeg zone. Drops it off for John Drew. Right in front for Leach, but it gets away from it. Into the corner for Wickenheim. Now back of the net. Start out once more. Hughes held up. Here's a centering pass blocked by Ellett. A shot that hit a skate. Goes for the right wing board. Rouse keeps it inside the zone. Dave Ellett tries to bring it out of the zone and carries to center ice and dumps it back inside the Washington zone. Scott Stevens back to pick it up. Over to Bob Rouse. Capitals lead 3-0 here. 11 minutes to play in the first period. Pavanka, Cortnall, and Johansson all striking early for the Caps. Jim Kite to the corner. He's bumped by Dino Cicerelli. Cicerelli moves it along. Grabbed on the backboard. Taken out of the zone by Brad Berry. Paul Fenton picks it up. Carries to center ice. Gustafson ties him up and is thrown back into the Washington zone. Here's Rouse moving it to center. Grabbed there by Gustafson. Long pass picked up by Johansson at the line and taken away. The Jets come back. Thomas Steen leads it now to Ashton. He's inside the Washington zone. Takes a drop pass. Walks in and shoots. And Peters makes a stick save. Back come the Capitals on the attack as Christian lugs it back to center. It hops past Jim Kite. Goes all the way into the Winnipeg zone. Leahy. Up the boards for Kelly Miller. He finds Pavanka loose at center. Inside the line. Looks for Ridley. Taken away by Taglianetti. And now in the corner, here's Ridley to go place it. Right in front. Off Sheehy's stick. Back to the point for Pavanka. Kelly Miller can't get free in the corner. Ridley does, but has the puck knocked away. Carlisle sends it off the boards and all the way down. The icing waves off. Really a needless scoring chance for Winnipeg moments ago, Al, when somebody took the man. Peters came up with a big stop.
I think there may be a little bit of confusion still if Bob Rouse out there with Gus.
Here's Ridley, a pass, a deep, and it's played away from in front of the net by Redding. Back to the point, Stevens a drive, and Redding kicks that away. Boschman works ahead to center ice. Gets across the line. He fires, and Peters with a big pass save. Scott Stevens works to center ice. Stevens gets across the blue line to Courtnall. Courtnall spun around, and the puck played out of the zone. Carter back to center, and Felix tosses it on into Winnipeg territory. Ellis behind the net. It's pressured by Courtnall's forechecking, and now the puck played all the way down, but right on net, no icing. Peters sends it up the right wing board. Just gets away from Ellis and circles back into the Winnipeg zone. 3-0 score. Capitals have the lead with 8.5 minutes to play here in period one at the Capitals Center. Mike Forns with Al Koken and Jeff Rimmer here on Home Team Sports. Ashton carries it into the Washington zone on his backhand. Takes it behind the net. He centers. Peters kicks it out. It's loose in front and finally cleared to the corner. Courtnall throws a big hit on Thomas Steen. And the Caps come back on 3-on-2. Here's Johansson to the blue line. And offside is called against Washington.
Remember, if you have a Moat, Cash Flow, or Money Exchange ATM card, you can get quick cash and account balance information at the cashier machine in any Giant food store. Boy, some good chances for Winnipeg to come back in this game, and is Pete Peters standing up well. When he's on his game, he's not flopping. He's coming out and attacking aggressively, and he really does the job. Here's the last save he makes. He just stands there, lets the puck play him. He guides it out a little bit away from traffic eventually. Before that, you mentioned the Ashton play, Mike, where Bob Rouse and Ben Gustafson, I think, got confused. Rouse, you know, coming from a different system. Gustafson is anticipating what the defenseman normally will do. This is something that will have to be worked out. Bob Rouse talking about some plays that he's had since he's been a Capital where he's a little uncertain with what exactly the responsibility are because there are some differences in Brian Murray's system from Pierre Paget's system in Minnesota. Those things will iron themselves out, but certainly look great when Pete Peters comes up big like that.
How many systems has Brent Ashton been in?
He could be writing a book on this.
Here's Bruce trying to clear it out of the zone. And now the puck has been knocked down by a high stick. And right away, the whistle blows to stop play. There's a break in the action with a score. The Capitals 3 and the Jets nothing.
Introducing Coca Color Gold 100. Coca Color Gold 100 gives you the truest colors of any print film.
Don't be afraid to
listen. A new Coca Color Gold.
Stop by any People's Drugstore and stock up with Coda Color Gold Film.
Part of the 18,130 looking on tonight. I guess that's the great barometer, Mike, about how far this franchise has come. You're selling out Tuesday night games with the Winnipeg Jets. You definitely are.
You're also doing pretty well when you start drawing from the Scottish Embassy. 3-0 score, 7.5 minutes to go here in the first period. Wickenheiser puts it off the backboards for Johansson, and he tips it out to center ice. Randy Carlisle dumps it back into Washington territory, and Pete Peters plays it up the corner boards. Now it's sent right across the goal mouth. Nobody there. Back to the point for Carlisle. His drive tipped wide. Boschman puts it off the boards, and John Drews carries it out now for Washington. Gets inside the Winnipeg zone to Steve Leach. Bumped by Carlisle. And played all the way back into the Capital zone. Langway over to Sheehy. Up to Gustafson across the line. Now to Christian. Back to Gustafson. it out to center ice. At the blue line, here's a wrist shot wide. Ashton goes to the corner. Jammed up there, and finally, he's held up and play is called. Let's check in downstairs with Jeff Rimmer.
Thanks, Mike. One game on our home team sports scoreboard thus far. The Hartford Whalers, who the Caps will travel and face on Saturday night, get a couple of goals from John Anderson. They lead 2-0 now in that first period of play. Tomorrow afternoon, Orioles exhibition baseball. They'll play the National League Eastern Division champion New York Mets. We'll have coverage for you beginning at 1:30 here on HBS. The Capitals right back at it here at the Cap Center Friday night against the Montreal Canadiens. Tickets are all gone. It is a sellout, but we'll have it for you in its entirety right here on HBS. Pre-game show 7:30, face-off at 8:05. Back upstairs.
6 minutes and 24 seconds to go here in the first period. Washington's goal scoring from Michael Pavanka, Jeff Cortnall, and Callie Johansson. Caps have outshot the Jets 8-6 thus far. Winnipeg has not been without their chances. Pete Peters with some big saves. Here's Olsson centering. Here Peters stops another shot. This time it was Thomas Steen that he denied. Gustafson in behind the net. Is hit. Langway tries to work it off the back of the netting, and just as he does so, the whistle blows. And the play is called.
There you get to see just how important Olsson and Ellis, the defense combo, are to the Winnipeg attack. See the way Olsson sneaks it along the board, pinches in there. He's the guy who really starts that play. Puts it right on the stick of Thomas Steen, and again, Pete Peters has to come up with another strong save. The Jets eventually may be more worse into the Caps than any line combination that Rick Bonus puts out there. Howard Tech line, Steen line, whatever. If they really think the key to that attack right now is controlling Ellis and Olsson, because they dominate back there on the blue line.
Offensively, they can sure do a lot. Defensively, the Jets have allowed 314 goals against. That's the most goals against in the National Hockey League. Here's a slap shot from the point, blocked by Donnelly. It goes to the corner. He throws it behind the net, but Ridley can't get rid of it. Bostrom puts it right in front, and Peters stops it. That backhand shot. Now Kelly Miller inside the Winnipeg zone. Skates to the corner, looks for Pavanka. He's held up on the play. Now Ridley puts it behind the goal for Kelly Miller. Miller checks, chases it in behind the net. Ridley tries to work free. Ridley jams up there. Pavanka finally skates away with a puck. Michael Pavanka right in front. Ridley turns around and shot, and a goal! A tremendous backhand effort by Mike Ridley. He picks the top corner, going over everybody's shoulders. And the Capitals are in the lead, 4-0.
Watch the spin move. It's almost like a Dennis Savard type of move. Backhand stops, spins, boom. Gets it away as Reddick goes down. Outstanding play by Ridley, but how is the play Michael Pavanka make? He gets rattled with the check, and yet still comes out of that pile with the puck and is able to get it onto the stick of Ridley. Pavanka's been hit. Still comes out, makes a perfect pass. Brent Hughes is all over Ridley. And look at that spin move to set that backhander over Pokey Reddick, who was bailing out on the play. That's an area the Capitals have exploited twice tonight. He can shoot high on Pokey Reddick. He's basically a stand-up goaltender, even though he's small, but he will go down. He's always in that crouching position. Gives you some room up top, and you see there it kind of bails out a little early.
It's the 36th goal of the season for Mike Ridley. Pavanka and Miller assisting at 14-31. So the scoring lead in the goal column tied once again. Cortnall had his 36th earlier, and now Ridley has evened him up. Here's Scott Stevens in behind the Washington net. Starts out with a right-wing pass to Bobby Gould. Gould to center ice, dumps it back inside the Jet zone, and Fenton clears it up the board. Hunter keeps it in. Thrown rink-wide. Gould has it taken away now by Carlisle, who tosses back to center. Capitals 4, Jets nothing. 4.5 minutes to play here in the first period. Routes to Gould at the blue line. Gives to Hunter. Deeks his way in. Can't get the shot off. Now Gould in front for Kortnoff. That bounces away from the net. On the right wing, here's a break for Ashton. Cutting in. Fires. Peters the save. gets it to Bobby Gould. Out now to Hunter. At the blue line of Winnipeg, and Steen works it back out to neutral territory. Both the Capitals and the Jets have changed lines once again, and here's Olofsson into the corner. On the left wing board. Brent Hughes fires wide. Turned around in front of the net. Sheehy works it free to Rod Langway. At the point, Ellett keeps it in. Peters handles that and covers up. There's a break in the action. Washington holds a 4-0 lead over the Winnipeg Jets.
An 89 Geo Metro is just $117 a month. An 89 S10 pickup is just $132 a month. An 89 Cavalier is just $137 a month. Where? At All-Star Chevrolet in Elkridge. Convenient from everywhere. All-Star deep buying services, fleet prices, and credit unions. Fact is, if you can buy it cheaper anywhere else, buy it.
With 3:33 to play in the first period, the Caps enjoying a 4-0 lead. Pavanka, Courtnell, Johansson, and Ridley, the goal scorers. Michael Pavanka with a goal and two assists in this hockey game so far.
Here's Randy Gillen in the corner, throws it behind the Washington net. Langway steers it out and brings it ahead to Wickenheiser. Doug Wickenheiser dumps it back inside the Winnipeg zone. Off the right wing board. Here comes Olofsson to start out. Peters shovels to the corner and Wickenheiser back to play it. Out to Rod Langway at center. He goes left side. John Drews breaks in, stops, fires, right on, and a save made by Pokey Redick. Leaps a little slow in getting up after being hit behind the net. Here's Gillen to the corner, and now as the puck is touched, the whistle blows, and play is stopped with 2:47 to go in the first period. Puck cleared out of play. Like a little mending job going to be necessary there for the linesman. Got a skate lace?
That's certainly seen enough action. Where the Capitals have been buzzing. Pokey Redick with the save. As John Drew spins around. And you see how Stephen Leach flips that net. That's where the netting comes loose a little bit there. Stephen Leach goes by.
Officials pay a lot of attention, not only before the game starts, but before each period starts, and making sure that those nets are just perfect. You know, in the old days, especially in the minor league, a lot of times you'd see netting get stretched, see a little hole here and there, and there'd be the occasional brouhaha when one would get in the wrong way. But not today, not in this game today. They pay very close attention to the netting on that goal. Here's Fenton to start out. Brings it ahead to center ice and dumps it back inside the Washington zone. At the point, here's a slap shot deflected up high off the glass. Felix starts out. The pass is beyond Cicerelli. And Kite goes back into his own zone to get it for Winnipeg. Scott Stevens has the play broken up, and now Fenton tosses it back inside the Washington zone. Felix tries to work it loose and gets it into the corner for Scott Stevens. Here's Gustafson to Cicerelli. Gets across the line to Dave Christian. Drops it for Cicerelli in the corner. Dino Cicerelli back to Bengt Gustafson. And tips it to the point. Gustafson keeps it in. Cicerelli goes behind the net. The Jets keep it moving. Brad Berry starts out. And off the boards, it's cleared all the way down back into the Washington zone. It'll be icing here as Rouse goes back to the touch, and the faceoff returns to the Winnipeg zone. Another sellout tonight, 18,130. That's number 19 on the year for the Washington Capitals. And number 20 will occur Friday night. The Capitals face off at 8:05 against the Montreal Canadiens.
Continuing to shatter all kinds of attendance records. And it's interesting, Mike, there hasn't been a Capitals front office was justifiably worried. Would some fans cancel season tickets because of the Mike Parker trade? Well, not only has nobody canceled season tickets, on Friday and Saturday alone, they sold 29 season tickets and 60 partial plans. Since the weekend, they've added 30 more season tickets and 50 more partial plans. So I think the fans catching some fever as well about the new look Capitals.
Here's Yarvinpah to start out. Dumps it back to the Washington line, and Ridley is there to take it. Passes ahead for Kelly Miller. Miller gets across the blue line. Worked free by Pete Taglianetti, and he throws it out to center. Callie Johansson fires it into the corner of the Jet zone. Gillen's back to get it. He works ahead to center ice with a minute to play here in the first period. Mike Ridley from center. Now back into the corner, and it's popped up, but settles down, and as Gillen moves it out, it has been forwarded with the gloved hand from Taglianetti. So play stopped. 47 seconds to go in the first period of play. Oh, just looking at the out-of-town score sheet that we've been given, Los Angeles at Quebec tonight, and Terry Gregson is refereeing once again after a week or so, 2 weeks of comeback work in the American Hockey League, and an awful shoulder injury that has kept him out, and they were saying it was going to be about the 1st of April before he could return, but he's evidently back and ready to go. Los Angeles plays Quebec tonight. Islanders at Hartford. Hartford has a 2-0 lead on goals by John Anderson. Boston at Pittsburgh tonight. Calgary at New Jersey. Toronto at Minnesota. Chicago at St. Louis. Jeff Rimmer will keep us up to date on all the scores throughout the broadcast. Here's an offside call, and Sheehy starts to talk it over now with Boschman and Ashton. Goaltending tonight, Lemlin for Boston against Barrasso for Pittsburgh. Hackett is in the net for the Islanders against former Washington Capitol farmhand Peter Sidorkiewicz for the Hartford Whalers. Kelly Rudy, who now wears the uniform of the Los Angeles Kings, in goal for L.A. tonight against Ron Tugnutt for Quebec. Mike Vernon goes for Calgary against Sean Burke of the New Jersey Devils. 30 seconds to go here in the first period. Ellett returns the puck to the Washington end. Lead pass beyond right winger Bobby Gould and picked up by Dave Ellett. Now out to Fenton. He dumps it into the Capitol zone. Langway turns it up the boards. It's kept in. Here's a wrist shot. Peters makes a stick save. Rebound bounced in front. Gould will get rid of this as time runs out on the clock. Here's a long drive wide at the horn. So the Capitals outshoot, or rather they end up tied in shots with the Jets 11-11 thanks to that last flurry in front of Pete Peters. But Pete doing some sound goaltending work as the Capitals jump on top of the Jets 4-0 after one period of play. More hockey coverage coming your way from the Capitol Center after these messages here on Home Team Sports.